Hi everyone, my name is Vinay. I am a software tester at Cordula Technologies. Today we'll see how to use loggers. We can do a lot of customization using the XML file, but today I'll go through the basics of loggers so that you guys can practice and also start implementing it in your projects. So now let's switch to the screen and continue. In this video, we'll see how to configure Log4j to XML file. These are the topics that we are going through in this video. So we'll see what is Log4j. Then we'll see how the default logging looks like without configuring the XML file. Then we'll configure the XML file and look at how to customize it. Then at last, we'll see how to store the generated logs in the specified file. What is Log4j? Log4j is a flexible, reliable, fast logging framework. So here, as you can see, this is the sample response that we get when logging. So here you can see this is the timeline. So when this log was generated, then these are the five main important logging levels. Then the part which you can see here is the path to the file for which the log was generated. Then this main part is the thread in which the program was running. So currently the program was run only in the single thread, so it is displaying as main. So these message what you are seeing here is the customized message. So we can print anything. Suppose the URL was this particular URL was it, or this URL is giving 404. So messages like that, we can customize this. Okay, now we'll see how the default logging looks like without configuring the XML file. So for this, we need to download the Log4j dependencies if it's a Maven project, or we can directly add the JAS to the build path. So now we'll go to Maven repository and here search for Log4j. Here we need to select this first option, Log4j core. Here we'll select the latest version. So here we can click here jar. This means you can see here files. So you can click on this jar and it will download the jars for us. See. So you can add those jars directly to the build path, or we can select this. And now we'll go to Eclipse. Now in the dependencies, we'll paste that. Okay, now we'll go to app and we can start configuring. So first we'll see how to declare it. So logger log, then type log manager. So first import this logger, import it from log4j core. Yeah, now hit control space. Here you can type get logger. Then inside this brackets, we need to give the class app.class.getName. So what this will do is, it will give the complete path of the app. Suppose you can see your app, right? So the path will be com loggers 1 and app. So that path will be given by this. So hover on this. So change type to logger. So it will import it. Now we'll create a method, import testng. Now I'm required to give any name for the method. Yeah, we imported test engine. So now to see how this works, I have written the logs here. So I'll just paste this. So since we can see this, this is the log, so object, right? So we use this object and here you can see log dot So here you can see all the levels that is provided by Log4j for logging. So all the five levels that we spoke earlier, so here it is. You can see debug, error, fatal, so you have info. So all the levels we'll get here. So these five will make use while logging. So as you can see, now we have not configured any XML file, right? So I'll just run this app now. Run as testng test. Okay, we'll go to console. See, as we can see here, only error and fatal is logged. But we have configured even info, debug and warn, right? So those are not visible here. That is because by default it is configured that in log4j only the errors will be printed. Errors, if we give both error and fatal, those are critical, right? So only those two will be printed by default. So this pattern what we see here, this time, this thread and this level, all these are default, already configured by log4j. So now we'll configure the log4j XML and we'll see how we can get even the info, debug and other levels also. Okay, now we'll see by configuring the XML file and taking a look at the responses by changing the logging levels, different logging levels, and by adding additivity, and also the we'll see what is append a reference, and also I'll explain you the pattern layout, what we should give the pattern layout. So now we'll go to Eclipse. So here we have not added the XML file yet, so I'll go to loggers, create a new file, and for this XML file we need to give the name as specifically like this, log4j2.xml, because log4j searches for this file name, only then it will execute. Now we click finish, and now we got an XML file. So this we can get it from log4j2 official page, so I'll show you in the end of this, by the end of this video. So now we have added this XML configuration, right? So this appenders, we need it to tell where we need to print, right? So we need to print in console, so we'll add console element. So this name we can give anything, and the target system should be system out, so it will be system outgo. Then we need to give the loggers element. So in this loggers element, we'll specify where we need to print, so and which file to print. Suppose here logger, I want this to apply only for this package, suppose. So in the name we need to specify the path of the package like this, so com.loggers.1. So that is the path. So whatever the logs will be printed, this particular thing will be applied only for this package. And one more here is root. So this root is mainly the logging will apply for the entire project, so one root will be must and should. So here appender reference is there. So this appender references will refer to this console element here. So whatever name we give here should be given here, so that it will be printed in the output. So I need to mention that in this. So for now I'll comment out this logger part. We'll see only the root, how it prints. So as I said, by default the entire root will be, the level will be printing is say error. So we want to print the other levels also, right? So we'll, to do that we need to change this level to trace. Trace means it will print everything, all these five levels. So we'll go to this XML file. So we'll save this, and now if I run this as testng test, you can see even though I have given as trace, still the output is giving only error. So why is that happening is the log4j is not able to find this. We need to add this file to the build path. For that we'll create a separate folder for that. Folder, so we can give it as resources. So this folder should be in the project level. So we'll drag and drop this inside this resources. And now we'll right click this, go to build path, configure build path. We'll go to source, then add folder. Now here you can see resources, click on resources, then OK. So that path is added as build path. So apply and close. See, now the icon is also changed. So this is a project level. It is applied. So now if I run this app, let's test engine test. See, now we can see entire log printed. You can see all the levels that we have mentioned here is being printed here. See, date, thread, everything. So we'll see how to change this pattern layout right now. So before that, let us remove this log apart and we'll see what is this about. So here you can see logger, I have applied for this package. Or if you want, we can apply it for specific Java class. So I'll take as app. See, app, right? So this will apply only for this class. So now both we are printing in console, append reference is same. Now if I run the app again, say run as test ng. Yeah, now you can see only error, right? Again, here we have given trace, even then here only error is displayed. That is because I have applied logger for that particular class. So if when a logger is applied to any class, this level will apply for that class. This level won't apply for that. So root level won't apply for particular class or a package when logger is added. So in logger level, we have put as error. So because of that error, we are getting only error here. So here, let me change for this for error, and I'll change this to trace. See, now we should get trace. We'll get everything. See, we got all the messages, but you would have noticed that we are getting the same logs twice here, right? So to avoid that, we need to add one more attribute called additivity equal to false. So what this does is, this won't run twice. So if you give us true here, it will run once for this and once for this. So this level won't apply for this. Level applied will be this level. But the logging will run once for root and once for logger. It will run twice, but the level applied will be this for both. So we can see twice response. So now I give an additivity as false. Now we'll see. Yeah, see, since we have given false, there is the response what you got is only once. Yeah, now let's come to this append as well. So here you can see as pattern layout. Right. So pattern, we can change how we want to display this, I mean record the logs. So this percentage stands for printing the output. So print, we want to print this time, date and time. So D is for date, and this is hours, minutes, seconds and milliseconds. So this, if you want to, don't want to show milliseconds, you can remove it. So, and this is T is for thread, it stands for thread that I said. Our project currently runs only in main since we are not doing multi-threading. So it will be mainly like this. And we want to also print the levels, right? Which level, what is the level? If you want to find the severity of the error or the warning, if we are finding some error in the log file, we need something to specifically see that error, right? So that is why these levels are printed here. So that we can print by giving percentage 5 level. But we can also reduce the number of alphabets shown here. Suppose we'll remove this, and in flower brackets I'll give length equal to 4. So when I do this, this length, so here our debug has 5 characters, right? So that last character will be removed, only 4 characters will be displayed. So that length we can specify if you want. Then again we want to print the path of this file. So as we saw earlier, here this is the path of that app, right? Particular Java class. So that we can print using this logger. In flower brackets we need to mention this 36. Here you can see 4 are there, com.loggers.1.app. 4 you can see, right? So suppose if I give 2 here, we will get to see only the last 2. These 2 we can see only the latest ones if I specify 2 here. If I give 3 here, we can see from like this loggers. So that we can specify that. And this is hyphen, and here percentage m refers to message. Whatever we give the message here inside this double quotes will be printed there. And this percentage n is for new line. If you didn't give this slash n, instead of this new line, the entire message will be printed in a single line. So we'll see that also now. So I'll remove the slash n for now, and I'll run the class again. See, as we can see, everything printed in a single line. So we'll keep the slash n and we'll run it again. See, as you can see, the milliseconds is not displayed here since we removed the triple S. And this thread is again main, it will be. And since the length I have given as 4, see, debug had 5, now it is displaying as only 4 characters, even fatal and error also. And this logger, see, I have given as 2, I told the last 2 will be displayed. So we can see last 2 is displayed. And again the message, what we want to print, that is printed. So I'll change this to 3 for now, and I'll run the test again. See, as you can see, from loggers it is coming. So this is how we can customize the pattern layout, how we want to display it in the, or record it in the file. Okay, in the next part we'll see how to print this response, what we get here, in a particular file that we mentioned. Now we'll see how to print the logs in a specified file. So for that we need to add the rolling file element in the XML file. Then we'll see what is the pattern layout for the file name, and also we need to create a new log if the size limit is exceeded. So we'll see how to do that, and also we'll change the log levels for both console and file, and we'll also see what should be the append or reference for rolling file element, and also we'll see the path how to add store the log files. Okay, now we'll switch to Eclipse. So here in the appenders there is an element called rolling file. So again this will be provided in the links in the PPT, so you guys can go through that. So we have added this rolling file. So the rolling file is, it will create a new file every time when this size exceeds. So this is the file name of that, and the file name, what we want the file name to be, we need to give it here. So for now, example, this, it is set to app.log, and this is the file pattern. So when the new file is created, it will be automatically created with this format. So this is the date, year and month, and inside that folder app, this name will be taken, and along with that date will be appended, and this I stands for increments. So every time a new file is created, this keeps a count of it. So this is the pattern layout. So how it should be printed, as we saw, similar to console. So it is similar to that. We'll see about that. And further, this is the policies. So this is size based triggering policy. So as I said, so when the file, this app.log file exceeds this limit, a new file will be created with this name. Okay, now let me create a package. Others.to. Now we'll just copy the same class and we'll rename it. We'll rename this also. Yeah, now we have another grid. So in XML file, so to see that in the root level, we change the appender reference. So this appender reference to print in the file, it should point to this, right? So it should print in a file. So we need to give this name here in the root level. So this logger is pointing to this, right? So we'll just see what it will print for this another new package that we created now. So I'll send this as testng test. See, test is run successfully. The output will not be printed in console. Now we'll go and refresh the project. Here, you can see app.log, right? So double click on this. See, we got our message here in the file. Okay. So now we'll change the level. So here root level, we have given a stress. So we got everything, right? So we'll change this to error. And now again, I'll run this. Run as testng test. Test is run successfully. Yeah, as we can see, only two are printed, that is fatal and error. Now we'll add logger for this second package. So I'll copy and paste it here. So I'll just rename it to second package. So let me keep this in package level. Okay, so for this entire package, this will apply. So here we need to change the appender reference. So we should change it to rolling file. Okay, now if I run this, this will apply and it will be printed, right? So let me run it as testng test. Yeah, test is run. And yeah, we got the errors here. Now we'll see, can we print both in file and console by adding two roots? I'll change this to console. And now, for now, I'll comment this out. So I'll run this. See, we got error. This is for, since we have given it to print in console, and we also got exception. So this is because we cannot use two roots in a same XML file. So we need to use either rolling file root or the console root. We cannot use both. Now we are printing in a file that, since we have given it a root, right? So now if this logger package or the Java file is run, then it will be printed in console as well as in a file if this additivity is not added. So for now, I'll remove this additivity and I'll run this first Java, that is first package. So we'll see how it prints in both console and file.
See, the error is printed in console as we go to, yeah, see log file. Even the message is printed here. So if we don't want to print in both the places, we need to add this additivity equal to false. If you want logs in both, then we need to make it as true or we have to remove it from the XML file. Okay, now we'll change this pattern and see how it reflects in the file. So this percentage D is same as this as we saw in console. It is similar to that. So again, if you want milliseconds, we can print milliseconds. And this percentage P is nothing but this level that we are printing. As we can see here, see, this is level. So that is printed in P. And this percentage C and this one dot is similar to this logger that we are printing. That is the path of the file that is being executed or the log is generated for. So that we can see from here. So if I remove this dot, now this we'll see that only this app will be displayed. If we keep that dot and if I change it to 2, then we can see 2 characters here. So we'll see that. So now I'll run this app 2. Run as testng test. The test is run successfully. See, now we have 2 characters. So that is because we have given 2 dot. If we remove the dot, similar to this, only the latest 2 will be displayed. The latest, this 2 and app 2. So we'll see that too. Test is executed and see, as we saw, the latest 2 path will be displayed. And this percentage T is similar to that thread, and this M and percentage M and percentage N is similar to message and new line. So this pattern is same, and again we can customize it however we want. We can replace it P, we can keep it at first or in last. So that depends on our customization. And we'll see this file pattern. So this new file will be created when this size limit is exceeded, right? So for now we'll reduce it to 2 KB. So when the file, this app.log file limit exceeds 2 KB, another file will be created inside this folder. A new folder will be created with the date, year and month. So this dollar sign tells that this is not a normal string. So it will get to know that we should print the day, year and month there. So a new folder will be created, and inside that folder, this app, then percentage T is again to print the date and time. So we'll mention what we want to display, and then it's percentage I, as I said, it will keep the count. So we'll run this and we'll check. So if the size exceeds 2 KB, then new file will be created. Let me refresh the project. So we'll change this to trace so the process will be faster. See, as we can see, another folder is created. Inside that folder, a new log file is generated. Now if I go to app.log, here the old messages, the entire message that got logged here will be moved to new file with the customized file pattern that we had given. Then again this will start logging the new log. So when this again process the 2 KB limit, again new file will be created and this one will change to 2. So this I will keep that count, every file count. So this is how we can customize this file pattern. And if we don't want to display this dot log, we want to display it in zip file. So then we can also give dot gz here itself. So when the limit exceeds, So we'll get that in zip file. So we'll see that.
I'll just copy paste this in this file, save the file. Now if I run this again,
if this is the project, see, now we can see it has created in a zip file. So we can even do that customization. We can also change this policy size to MB. So if you want a bigger file, so we can change this to MBs. So that we can do. And also in pattern layout, we can give not only time, we can also give date. So we can pass inside this card. So date is small d and capital M for month and year like this. And now if I run this, test is run, and yeah, as you can see the date along with the time is recorded. So even that we can customize. Now we'll see how can we store a particular log file in a particular folder, so we don't have to go and do it manually. So we can configure that also. So for that we need to use property stack. So I'll add this here. Now inside this base directory, we can give whatever the folder name we want. Inside this folder, this file will be placed. So this properties file, this name we should pass it here, so that this rolling file will get to know that it should place a log file inside this folder. So we can give any name for this. So for now I have named it as base directory, this property name. Now we need to give this base directory name here in the file name, so it will get to know. So to do that, we have to give dollar sign, then inside dollar brackets we need to pass that base directory name and slash. So now what it will do is it will create a folder with this name, and then inside that folder this app.log will be placed. So even we want any new file generated inside this logs folder, right? So for that, again copy the same thing and paste it here. So even the any new files created will be generated in a new inside that logs folder. So to see that, for now I'll delete this existing logs, app.log remove, and now I'll reduce this size to 1 KB to check. Now I'll run this app to run as test ng test. Test is run, we'll refresh the project. See, a logs folder is generated, right? So now we click this, see, app.log, we got the message. So we can do that automatically without doing manually. And if we exceed this 1 KB, this new file will also be placed inside this logs folder. So we'll see that too. This run. See, again if I run, change the test. Now I'll refresh the project. See, inside logs, so this is the path of the logs folder, right? And we have given, asked it to create another folder with the year and month. So it created year and month folder. Inside that folder, we have placed the app, the file name, dot log. So this hierarchy works there. So we can change the file pattern however we want. Also we can rename the folder to anything that is required for the project. Okay, we saw how to print the logs in a specified file, and also we added the rolling file element. We also saw how to change the pattern layout for the file name. We also created a new file when the size changes, right? And we also saw to by changing the logging levels for console and file. We also saw what should be the appender reference and the path how we should add by using properties element. So these are the references that I have provided here. So this is the log4j official documentation, and this is the same documentation. We can find the rolling file also, and this is the Maven repository link. So for that log4j dependencies, so here you can see this is the log4j official document. So you can scroll down, and here they have given mentioned everything and all the customizations that we can do in the XML file. So if we scroll down and click on this appenders, so here we can scroll through this entire page and we can see what other customizations we can perform in the XML file. See, as we can see here, many customizations are provided, and also we can see inside the appenders here rolling file is there. So see here they have provided the XML for that, even for rolling file. We can go through this and we can get what customizations we want for the project depending on the project. So thank you for watching the video. Feel free to use the comment section below. Bye.